The potential medalist after the short program of the pairs competition. Gordieva and Grinkov of the Soviet Union as expected in first place. The defending Olympic champions Valava and Vasiliev in second place. You saw Watson Opelgar of the United States third. Waxman and Wagner of the United States in an impressive fourth position. There you see the Canadians fifth and the other Soviet pair sixth. And with a quartet of extremely happy Americans, here is David Santee.
Well, I would think this would put to rest the critics who said the American team wasn't that strong.
I think so. The Americans have been challenging the top spots in pairs for the last couple of years now, Jill and I, and now it's really nice to have two teams in the top five. You've got to say the American pair skaters are strong now, and serve notice that we're here.
Were you guys surprised to be in fourth after the short?
We're not surprised, but we're thrilled right now. We've been working really hard this year, and it's paying off.
U.S. pair skaters aren't going to take a back seat anymore.
No more. Cancel that thought.
Well, the Russians are certainly going to come after you guys on Tuesday night. Let's go over to Dick and Peggy for a closing comment.
Well, I will tell you one thing. This was a wonderful competition for the North American skaters. I thought they all did beautifully, and that's a very satisfying and wonderful feeling.
Well, they all can feel so good about themselves that they did their best and they were really trying, and it's wonderful to see that. That's the best kind of competition to have.
And now we have one further problem, and that is the long program. Remember this, the short program is a lot easier. It is short and concise and controlled. When you get up into a 4 to 4.5 minute program, it's longer and much more complicated, and then the disaster happens. Tuesday night that's going to happen, and we'll see a different night altogether than what this was. That's my bet. Right, Jim? Back to you, Jim.
Okay, Dick, a delightful evening of skating, really, at the corral. Happy Americans. There is a very sad, grieving American in Calgary tonight. His name is Dan Jensen. If you haven't been following the events of the day, Dan Jensen's sister, of whom he was most beloved, died of leukemia this morning. This evening, Dan's big event, the 500 meters, in which he was the favorite, took place. He fell on the first turn and was out of the competition. Gary Bender talked to him a little bit later.
The Olympic Oval in Calgary is empty now, but earlier this evening it was the site of the men's 500-meter sprint and the U.S.'s best hope for a gold medal, Dan Jensen. He was the guy they hoped would come through, but Eric Heiden, it just didn't happen.
You know, when he started out, I thought he had a very good opening 100 meters. I didn't think anybody was going to go any faster, but apparently he had almost lost his edge, and when he hit the corner, it was just all over.
Well, he was battling to keep his concentration due to the fact that he had lost his sister Jane to cancer. He had a false start, Eric. Then he said that his first 100 wasn't normal. And then the unbelievable thing happened. He fell in the first turn, ending his quest for the gold. And it was just a devastating beginning for the United States.
Well, it was a sad and devastating day for America. You could see right there, all of a sudden, his left foot just slipped out from underneath him, and away he went, sailed off the track.
After it was all over, and after considerable time and agony, as you can imagine, because Dan Jensen had hoped to continue on after being the world sprint champion last week in Milwaukee, he held a collective press conference. Reflected back what had happened, his sister passing away early in the morning, he had talked to her earlier, and here's why it was so tough to concentrate.
Danny, what was your frame of mind when you were out warming up? Obviously due to the thoughts that were going through you, what was your frame of mind at that time?
Well, I wanted, you know, my family, I had talked with them before, and they all wanted me to just go out there and do the best I could and, you know, try to put as much out of my mind as I could. And I tried to do that, and I did it pretty well. And like I said, in the warm-up, just my skates just felt different out there. They weren't gripping the ice, and I didn't feel real solid. And I guess that's why I fell.
You had a false start. Did that also throw you off a little bit?
Yeah, a little, because, you know, not only, you know, I never fall, but I really have very rarely jump either. And I was kind of confused after I did that. It was a strange thing. I don't do it very often.
Could you tell us what transpired through the morning as far as the communication from home?
I got a call at about 6 o'clock this morning, and they wanted me to talk to Jane she was still alive, and she could understand me, but she couldn't talk back. But I got to talk to her, and I was very, very happy about that. And later on, I had called again, and my brother had told me that she had passed away.
The disappointment of Jansen opened the door for Uwe Mai of East Germany. He set a world record and got the gold, the first ever for East Germany in the 500 meters. Jan Ikema of the Netherlands, the silver. Akira Kuraiwa, the bronze from Japan. Nick Thomas finished in eighth place. Eric Hendrickson, 15th. Marty Pierce, 22nd. Dan Jensen, of course, did not finish. Not a very promising beginning for the United States in speed skating.
And just a tragic day for the Jansen family of West Allis, Wisconsin. Nine children in that family, a deeply religious family. And that's what they've got going for them tonight. Elsewhere around town, this is still Calgary, the city of the Olympics. Celebrations are going on down in the Olympic Plaza. Another 40,000 people, as there were last night, have been there all evening. There are going to be fireworks. We may get a look at those. We will be back in Calgary.
Japanese imports have long had a reputation for giving you more car for your money. But now that's just make-believe. Because Ford Escort, the world's best-selling car, offers the same features as Toyota Tercel, plus air conditioning, power mirrors, and a 660 powertrain warranty, all for less money than Tercel, which makes Ford Escort the real value.
Now, during Ford's Leadership Celebration, get a $400 cash bonus on Escort.
Wasn't supposed to start a revolution, but it did. Not because it was fashionable or trendy, but for a simpler reason. Something you could never convince people of, unless they tried it themselves. It made the things it's in taste better than anyone ever imagined. NutraSweet. Why so many things taste so good?
This is an uncertain time. Everybody knows it's an uncertain time. Rather than be totally paralyzed, CDs become an attractive alternative vehicle. Giving them the advice that we give them as to which CDs to purchase and which maturities and which are the most attractive interest rates, that's what we're all about. Merrill Lynch only offers insured CDs. And if our advice is better because our advisors are better, then doing business with Merrill Lynch is more attractive.
Merrill Lynch, a tradition of trust.
Every evening from now on here in Calgary, medals are going to be awarded down at the Olympic Plaza. As I said, a crowd, some 40,000 gathered again tonight as it did last night. It's going to be the real gathering place. The first medal was won by a Soviet, Vida Vincenne.
Vida Vincenne.
Now the Soviet flag being raised in the playing of their national anthem.
Played was that of the Soviet Union for Vida Vincenne, winner of the 10-kilometer cross-country race for women this morning. Then the fireworks, including this day. the first big day of competition, the day of tragedy, and the day of celebration. We've said so many times that the Olympics reflect life. More often than not, they reflect the way we wish the world was. Sometimes, in the case of the Jansen family today, they reflect all too clearly the way life can be. Downtown, celebration goes on. So as expected, Matti Nykänen won his first ski jump today on the 70-meter, favored to win the 90-meter later on in the games. In luge, the Americans didn't do too well. Our best finish was 14th, and in the ski jump, it was 18th. In the speed skating, the tragedy of Dan Jansen. The United States did not win any medals. They had hoped for two in the men's 500-meter speed skating race. We saw an upset in hockey and very interesting figure skating. As for tomorrow, well, let's take a look. Be sure to join us again tomorrow night, beginning at 8 Eastern time. We'll have downhill ski racing, the men's downhill, postponed from today at Mikiska at Mount Allen. The real test of man against the mountains. You'll see the great Spearman Zurbriggen, the favorite for that, a man who conceivably could win 5 gold medals here. It's going to be very, very exciting stuff. We'll also have live coverage of Team USA in a really big match for them against Czechoslovakia. Czechoslovakia is smarting from a surprise defeat by West Germany yesterday, but they have their first-string goalie back in tomorrow night. The Americans won their first game, the first time since 1960. They won their first game in the Olympic hockey tournament.
Olympic Winter Games have been brought to you by Maxwell House, coffee that's good to the last drop. Sunlight, powder, or liquid, nothing gets glasses more spotless. Merrill Lynch, an investment firm built on a tradition of trust. And NutraSweet, it's why so many things taste so good. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports. A promotional fee has been paid to ABC by American Airlines, a proud sponsor of the ABC telecast of the 1988 Winter Olympics. Tomorrow night, the excitement of the 15th Winter Olympics continues on ABC Sports. It's prime time, and the spotlight is on Team USA in ice hockey. They're off to a fast and furious start following their impressive win over Austria. Now they face the top team from Czechoslovakia live. Also, it's the run for the gold as the world's top skiers challenge the men's downhill. And it's a race against the clock in men's cross-country skiing. Plus more as the Olympic tradition continues.